This video is brought to you by Tokyo Treat and Sakura Co. And this super sexy Optimus Prime, the face of Transformers, doesn't transform. Fuck! Hey, my name is Javi, and we're looking at the Banana Force MPL-04 Orion Predator. And before we get into my conflicting feelings about this figure, let's grab something to eat. From today's sponsors, Tokyo Treat and Sakura Co. Tokyo Treat is a monthly Japanese subscription box full of popular Japanese candy and snacks, like Japan-exclusive Kit Kat, Ramune, Ramen, and a bunch of popular stuff. And Sakura Co. is also a monthly subscription box, but with more of a focus on traditional, authentic Japanese snacks from Japan's local artisan snack makers. Both are delivered straight to your door from Japan, and both boxes have a different theme every month. This month's theme is, of course, Valentine's Day.
But Jambi, it's January. Shut up.
You get February's theme if you order in January, March's theme if you order in February, and so on and so on. Makes it the perfect gift for your significant other, which in my case is myself. And don't worry if you don't know what any of this is. There's a booklet explaining every snack included in the box. This popcorn shrimp popcorn is one of the best snacks I've had in a long time. So check out the link in the description and use code KITKAT22 to get a bonus Kit Kat with your first Tokyo Treat order. And use code TIGER to get bonus Japanese home goodies with your first Sakura Co. box. But keep in mind that this promotion is only valid till the end of this month. So thanks for sponsoring, you lovely boxes. And thanks for keeping me well paid, well fed. Now let's open up this box. First of all, you gotta get through a cardboard box that has some cool art on it. So, Orion Predator here is a third-party Optimus Prime. Obviously, he's hyper-stylized and non-transformable. As you know if you've been subscribed for a while, subscribe if you haven't, I'm someone who likes Transformers because they, you know, transform. So you might be wondering why I would even touch something like this. Bruh! A long time ago, I said that I would take a look at more non-transforming Transformers if I got it free. And I did. Shout out to Banana Force themselves and the show that's in the description. But just because I got this guy for free does not mean I will pull any punches. But the painting and sculpting is amazing. It's undeniably impressive purely in terms of craftsmanship. All the painting here is super clean. Everything looks high quality. There's really no place that looks rushed or amateurish. But admittedly, I'm not too big on the super stylized anime look. Even though I love Japanese culture and Japanese snacks, check out Tokyo Treat and Sakura Co. But I know for a fact that a lot of you will find this design absolutely mind-blowing. And I can't blame you. Even I, the G1 slut that I am, can tell that a lot of work went into this design, especially when you really zoom in. The small details here are excellently done. I'm really digging those super shiny metallic parts. The little rivets, the panel lining, all expertly executed. And I love the integration of clear parts. There's just a tiny bit in the calves. And of course, there's the chest, where you get a good glimpse at the matrix of leadership. Spread the titties, flip this up, and I think that it's magnetized. Definitely magnetized, it's not falling out. I would have preferred a more intense color for the matrix. This clear light blue is a little dull. And that's a bit of a loose magnet, but it gets the job done. The head sculpt also gets the job done. This thing looks nice. It also looks like nice. Just me. I mean, it does read as Optimus, antennas and all. Don't attempt to rotate these too far, by the way. It might snap something off if you force it. I just think his face looks a bit too narrow. And his clear blue eyes a little too big. Kinda kawaii. And speaking of Japanese culture, Optimus looking a bit submissive and breedable. Also, the lack of paint on the eyes makes him look dead. Which makes him look more submissive and... Banana Force missed the prime opportunity to include a light-up feature. And if this mask is too boring for you, which, no shame in that, masks are boring for everyone at this point, you do get an alternate head. Bit of a tight fit. And I don't know about this one. The helmet is exactly the same, but the mask has a more bestial look to it, I guess? Maybe it's a tease for an Optimus Primal figure, I mean... Come on. I really don't understand it, but it's there if you want it. I'll stick with the classic. And what's a Jobby the Hong Transformers review if I didn't mention the back? Lives don't matter in this case, because he doesn't transform if you didn't know already. If anything, the back needs a little something to fill it in. Oh, that's better. Slide it down to lock it in place. Not the most impressive wingspan, but it looks good. And you get a rotation, and he can flap his tiny little wings. And there's a peg at the back where you can plug in this ion blaster. But because the peg is a hexagon, as opposed to a perfect circle, you can't see once it's plugged in. However, it does lock into pretty good position, so no problem there. And the blaster itself looks fantastic. Really cool redesign of an iconic weapon. It's even got a light-up feature if you tug at the tip, which doesn't work. Like my thing. Oh, it doesn't have any batteries. That's just a magnetic cover on a standard screw. Put some obscure-ass batteries in there, which are not in the instructions, for frick's sake. By the way, the booklet looks really cool, but it's not a booklet. It's one of them annoying foldouts, for frick's sake. Now let's pull on that barrel. Either my batteries are dead, which I doubt, they were fresh as fuck, or my copy is busted. Now, I did see this thing light up once, for a second, before it shut off forever. But even if it did work as intended, it doesn't look that great. This is footage from Kuma Style's review, by the way. Shoutouts to him for letting us know what batteries are required. Go check him out, he's cool. And as if this wasn't disappointing enough, let's switch out the fists. The hands are a softer plastic, so they pop off fairly easily. Get these trigger finger hands on here, plug in the blaster, or not. Maybe the looseness of this grip is intentional design to make it easily removable, but I don't know. This feels like a huge oversight. I'm sure there's ways to tighten that grip. You can always heat this up with the hairdryer for a few seconds, squeezing it to shrink that hole, effectively reshaping it, and dipping it in cold water to lock its new shape. But you shouldn't have to do all that. His grip is as female as his face. I didn't mean it. I kind of meant it. He can switch out the trigger finger hands for this pair of grabby hands, which also have a pathetic bitch grip. At least there's a way to lock these axes into position. Very impressive pair of weapons with a pretty sharp blade. Ah! But if it's too big for you, tell your partner that it's not gonna work out. You could segment the axes and adjust the height. I prefer the short look. The extra parts have nowhere to go, so put them in a baggie or put it in your ass. And only one axe at a time, one weapon at a time, can plug into his back. Kind of disappointing that the weapon storage is so limited. And you get these tires. If you're like me, a completely normal person who likes transformers that transform, don't get your hopes up. Remove the calves. These are also magnetized. Attach the tires and yeah, these are just for aesthetic purposes. Kibble? That doesn't do anything. Why do I feel offended? Like, you don't even transform. What gives you the right to have tire calves? Transformation appropriation. Nah, I'm just messing with you. Kind of. Options are always good, but I prefer the plain calves. So with impressive craftsmanship, a good variety of accessories, there's not much I can complain about the look of this guy. So how does he feel? Really satisfying. Just by picking him up, you can tell that there's a lot of die-cast metal in here. Makes sense, he's part of the metal premium line after all. I'm pretty sure most of his internal structure is made out of metal. The spine and joints look and feel a certain way. Also, I have a kitchen scale now and make of that what you will. I don't know how to read, but I do know how to pose.
The time has come.
Ball joint at the head. Every ball joint's a swivel. Hinge joint at the neck. Full rotation at the shoulder. Very limited butterfly joint. Huh. And the shoulder flaps are super loose, just flip them upside down to get them working. And that allows the shoulder to move up. Hinge joint at the smokestacks. That allows the arm to move out. Bicep swivel. Double bend at the elbow. Ball joint at the wrist. Every ball joint can be side to side. Excellent ab crunch thanks to a series of hinge joints, which reveals more of his spine. Something I'm severely lacking. Okay, that female grip choke, I mean it times four! Not much of an arching back. A full waist swivel. And no side to side movement. Huh. Front skirts are loose. Side skirts are weirdly tight. No butt skirts. Pretty good kick. Can move back that far. And a damn good spread. Thigh swivel. Bend at the knee. With a beautifully clicky ratchet joint. The only ratchet joint, unfortunately. And you can see the top thigh panel slide down a little bit. Hinge joint here. Ankle moves down and up. A downward bend at the toe? Huh? A hinge joint at the heel? Huh? And a surprisingly pathetic pivot. Ha! While there is a ton of articulation here, and the joints feel nice and solid, the fact that this guy doesn't transform should have freed up the designers to engineer some posability gimmicks. Something as simple as an extending ankle to clear some space for a deeper pivot. Or a collapsible waist that, when you pull it up, reveals a ball joint. Just some ideas that I got from the Mastermind Creations Optus Pexis, yet another third-party Optimus Prime. I always get a point on how much I talk about this character. He is my best friend after all. That figure is a gold standard for super posable action figures in general. And he transforms. There really is no excuse for Banana Boy over here to be lacking posability in some areas. That's not awful, just a bit surprising. At least he's big, that's always nice. Size comparison time. Here's Figma Modic Economy, SH Monster Arts Godzilla, Transform Element OP Leader, MP36 Masterpiece Megatron, and the review that was supposed to come out today, but I had to delay it again because Banana Force started asking where this review was. Well, here it is! Hope I didn't kick your ass too hard. So I just noticed there's a slot similar to the slot on the back at the bottom of the feet. I also found ports on the shoulders, the arms, and there's that taint hole. Maybe this optosy is for a stand, which is not included. Or maybe there's gonna be some kind of upgrade or accessory pack. Ultra Magnus, perhaps? That would actually be kind of cool. And this figure, overall, is kind of cool. There's a lot to love here, and it's clear that Banana Force has a lot of talent behind it. Just look at their previous release. That thing looks sick. But it's still not quite my thing. I still do not have any reason to willingly buy Transformers that don't transform. Can't even fake a transformation, SMH. But if it's your thing, I recommend it. The design is still pretty cool, though. But he looks less like a Transformer and more like a cry about my non-transforming Transformers opinions all you want. But there are some toys out there that have no business transforming, yet they do. For real this time, I swear.